Good morning, my dear students. In the previous class, I have explained about the rational numbers, properties of rational numbers. And again, in the next video, I explained about the questions. Means I have solved some questions based on addition and subtraction of rational numbers. In this class, I am going to explain you how to solve questions based on multiplication and division of rational numbers. Clear? So now let's start the class with this question. So question number one. The question number one is evaluate -11/9 into -51/-44. So this is the question. -11/9 into -51/-54. How will you evaluate this one? So the first thing here, you can see in numerator as well as in denominator minus sign is there. What we will do? I have explained earlier also. We will cancel the sign. Clear? So we will write in simplified form. That is it. -11/9 into 51/44. Clear? So this one and this one is what? Cancel. Now, how many times? 11 fours are 44. Okay. Now, can we cancel 9 and 51? Yes. 3 is the common factor of 51 and 9. Okay. So, 3 threes are 9 and 3 ones are 3. 2 here, 3 sevens are 21. Now, can we cancel any number? No. We cannot cancel because there is no common factor that can divide any two numbers. So, this will be the answer. So, what answer we will get here? -17/12. This is the answer. Okay, now let's do the next question. I hope you all are also solving the questions and you must have got the same answer. Clear? If you have not got the same answer, no problem. The basic concept I have given here, just go through it and I know next question you will be able to solve. So now the next question. -36/-7 into -9/28. Clear? This you have to solve. This is the question. 36/-7 into -9/28. Again, what you can do? We can cancel the minus sign. Because numerator and denominator both have minus sign. So, we can cancel. So, now what we have at last? We have 36/7 into 9/28. Now, check. Can we cancel any number? So, 2. So, 2 ones are 2 and 2 eights are 16. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. Okay. Now, can we cancel? Just check. No, we cannot cancel any other number because there is no common factor of any two numbers that can divide that number. So, what we will do? We will multiply. So, what numbers we have got it here? 18 into 9/7 into 14. Clear? So, 18 into 9 means what? 162 and 7 into 14. 98. Yeah. Again we can cancel. Yes. Here also we can cancel. Because this is divisible by 2. So no problem. Here also we can divide. So 2 8s are 16. 2 1s are 2. 2 4s are 8. And 2 9s are 18. Yeah. Again, is it possible? No, now it is not possible. So, answer will be what? 81/49. Yeah. If you want, you can change it in the mixed fraction also. Okay? Clear to all of you? I hope you have also got the same answer. Now, let's do the next question. into 1 by 4. Then minus inside the bracket minus 18 by 7 into minus 7 by 15. Here, this is the question for which solve it. So here 2 into 1 by 4. So this is the question, here we can write it. 2 into 1 by 4. Then here minus 18 by 7 into minus 7 by 15. What we can do here? Here we can cancel, 2 2's are 4. Then here can we cancel? 7 and 7 we can cancel. 18 and 15 also we can cancel by 3. So 3 6's are and 3 5's are. Okay, so what we have at last? 1 by 2 minus. This minus and this minus is what? Plus. Okay, so 6 by 5. Now we'll take out what? We'll take out the LCM. So LCM is 10. Then 2 5's are 10, means 5. Minus 5 2's are 10, so 6 2's are 12. So minus 7 by 10 answer. What answer you will get here? Minus 7 by 10. Okay, so the process is clear. Here what we can do? We can cancel 2 2's are 4. Because we have to do first the bracket work and two small brackets are here. So simultaneously we can do it. Then here minus sign is here and minus sign is here. So minus into minus plus. Because in between multiplication sign is given here. Clear? Then 7 and 7 cancel, 18 and 15. What is the common factor of 18 and 15? Yes, 3. 3 6 are 18, 3 5 are 15. Okay, so here we have got 1 by 2 minus 6 by 5. You know how to solve it. We will find out the LCM, then we will solve it. And at last, we got what answer? Minus 7 by 10. Yeah. At last, what answer we have got? Minus 7 by 10. Okay, now let's do the next question. Again, different type of question. Next question is 2 by minus 3 into 5 by 4 plus 5 by 9 into 3 by minus 10. This is also inside the bracket. So this is the question. How we solve it? So first what we will write? First we will write the question. Okay. So this part is given here, we will write down. 2 by minus 3 into 5 by 4 and then here we can write plus sign. Be careful. 5 by 9 into 3 by minus 10. So can we cancel? Yes. 2 2's are 4. Here 2 2's are 4. This you know we can cancel it. Then here 5 2's are 10. 3 3's are 9. So what we have? We have 5 by minus 6. Here, plus what? This is cancelled. So 1 minus 1 by minus 6. Plus 6 minus you write 1 by 6 or 1 by minus 6 is same. So what we have at last? Minus 5 by 6 minus 1 by 6. Clear? So again this is same. So minus 5 minus 1 minus what? Minus 5 by minus 6. Okay, this is plus and here minus 1. So minus 5 minus 1 minus 6. Here 6. 6 and 6 cancel. What is it? Left minus 1. So minus 1 will be the answer. Clear? I hope it is clear. And you have also got the same answer? Yes. I'm sure you must have got the same answer. So now let's do the next question. Now, again I'm going to do the different types of questions. Clear? That type of question you can get in this chapter. Okay, so evaluate, how to evaluate I have done. Now I am going to explain you how to verify multiplied by using certain properties. So the question is, verify that the multiplication is commutative. Verify that the multiplication is commutative. Okay, so this type of question also you can get. Clear? Because you know, in chapter I explained different types of questions so that my students can do all different types of questions without getting any problem. Okay, so this is the another type of question that you can get in this chapter. So the question is minus 1 by 5 and 2 by 9. Okay? So this is based on this. Verify that the multiplication is commutative, and this is the given, the fraction is given here. What is the property of multiplication, means commutative property? What we write, how we come to know that the given property is what commutative? So just remind that I have explained in my previous video, a by b into a by b into c by d is equal to c by d into a by b. This is what, this is means through this you come to know that this is based on which property? Commutative property. Means in commutative property we arrange the numbers this way. Okay? So let's arrange these, this number also like this. So minus 1 by 5. So here you write it minus 1 by 5 into 2 by 9. And this should be equal to what? 2 by 9 into minus 1 by 5. So what, can we cancel anything? No. So 2 by what? 9 5s are 45. And this is it equal? Yes, this is equal. Means what? This is verified. The commutative property is verified. So here you can write what? Verified. Verified. Okay. So whenever you get this type of question, clear? Whenever you get this type of question in which you have to solve, you have to verify the given property, first you write that how we arrange the numbers in that property. So like in commutative property, we arrange the numbers this way. So first you write this, and then accordingly you arrange the numbers. Okay, now let's do the next question. Next, different types of question. Write the reciprocal or multiplicative inverse of given rational number. Multiplicative inverse of given rational numbers. Okay, so the first one is given here 5. Second one I am taking minus 3. Third one I am taking minus 7 by minus 8. Fourth one I am taking minus 3 by 5 into minus 1 by 13. And fifth one I am taking here minus 8 by minus 7. Okay, so This is the another type of question. Means in this chapter you can get question like this also. That write the reciprocal or multiplicative inverse of the given rational number. Multiplicative inverse means what? Reciprocal of that number. Reciprocal means what? Means numerator you write as denominator and denominator you write as a numerator. Okay. So here it is 5. What will be the multiplicative inverse of 5? Yes, very good. 1/5. Clear? So here we will write what? Here we will write 1/5. -3. 1/-3. Then -7 and -8. So this minus is cancelled. We can cancel here. What is left here? 7/8. What will be the multiplicative inverse of 7/8? 8/7. Very good. So here you can write 8/7. Then here also you can see. Here is minus sign given. And here is also minus sign given. So this is what? Cancelled. What is left? 3/65. So we will write 3/65. But this is not the answer. We have to write it what? Again, 65/3. Clear? So correct answer will be what? Correct answer will be 65/3. Because this is the solution. This one is what? This one is the solution of this one. Clear? But the multiplicative inverse, here is comma. So multiplicative inverse of 3/65 will be what? 65/3. Okay, now here -8/-7. What we will do? We will first cancel minus sign. Okay, then it is 8/7 and multiplicative inverse of this will be what? 7/8. Okay, so whenever this type of question comes, just you write the reciprocal of the given number. Okay, now the next question. Verify that. Please verify that. So the first one I am solving here. X plus Y into Z is equal to X into Z plus Y into Z. When X is what? When X is given 2, Y is given 4/5 and Z is given 3/-10. Okay, this is the question. So again, this is different types of question. That this is a different type that you can get in this chapter, in this exercise. Clear? So what is that? Verify that. Means here the property is not given. It is written, the equation is written and the value that you have to take for X, Y, Z is given. And you have to verify. Verify means you have to prove that the right hand side is equal to the left hand side. Okay. So here, this one is what? This one is right hand side. R, H, S. Right hand. This is what? Right hand side. And this one is what? L, H, S. L, H, S means what? Left and side. Okay, so now solve it. So first we solve the right hand LHS. Okay, so first let's solve LHS. So X plus Y, X is what? 2 plus 4/5 into Z is what? -3/10. So when you solve it, what we get here? So LCM. So here it will be what? 5, 10 plus 4. Yeah. Then this into -3/10. Again this you can write 14/5 into -3/10. So can we cancel? Yes. 2 5s are 10, 2 7s are 14. Yeah. 2 5s are 10, 2 7s are 14. Means -21/25. So, in LHS what we have got? -21/25. So, let's write this one here. -21/25. Because I am going to rub this one so that we can solve RHS also. Okay. Now next one is RHS. What is given? X into Y. X is 2 into X into Z. Z is what? Minus 3 by 10 plus Y is what? 4 by 5 into minus 3 by 10. Clear? So now this we can cancel. So minus 3 by 5. And here also, yes, 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10. Clear? So what we have? Plus minus 6 by 5 5s are 25. Okay? So now take out the LCM. When we take out the LCM, what we get here? 25 and 5 5s are 25. 3 5s are 15. Then here minus 5, 25, 1 and 6. So minus 15 and 6. This will be what? Minus 21 by 25. Okay? So here also we have got what? Minus 21 by 25. Here also we go to what? Minus 21 by 25. Clear? Means both the side we have got the same answer. Means right hand side is equal to the left hand side. Okay? So this is verified. So at last we can write what? We can write after solving. We can write here that RHS equal to LHS and this is what? Verified. Okay? Now, I am going to solve one more question based on this. Okay? X into Y minus Z is equal to X into Y minus X into Z if X is given what? If X is given 4 by 5, Y is given minus 7 by 4 and Z is given 3. We have to solve it. Means what? We have to verify it. Again, this is what? LHS, this one is what? RHS. This one is LHS, this one is RHS. Again, same process we will do. But here, sign is different, number is different. Huh? So, and you know, practice makes man perfect. So, here, take first what? First, I am taking this one. This is what? LHS. So, X. X is what here? X is 4 by 5 into Y is what? Minus 7 by 4. Then, minus 3. Okay, so when you solve it, what will get here? So, 4 by 5 into, here we take the LCM 4, minus 7, minus 4, 4 3 is a 12. So, here we will get what? Here we will get 4 by 5 into minus, minus and minus, plus. We will do the addition, but sign which one will we put? Minus. So, minus what? 19 by 4. Okay? So, this 4 and this 4 is cancelled. So, what we have? Minus 19 by 5. So, in LHS what we have got? Minus 19 by 5. So, LHS we got minus 19 by 5. Now, let's solve RHS. Okay? So, RHS. X into Y. 4 by 5 into Y is what? Minus 7 by 4. Then minus X. X is what? 4 by 5 into Z is what? 3. Clear? So now solve it. How will we solve it? Can we cancel? Yes. Here we can cancel. So minus 7 by 5 minus what? 12 by 5. Clear? So what we have? LCM 5. Minus 7, minus 12 and this is equal to what? Minus 19 by 5. This is same that we have got it here. Okay. Again what we will write? RHS equal to LHS and verify. Okay. So at last we can write LHS equal to RHS and verify. Clear? So this much is only for this video, and all different types of questions that can come in this exercise I have done. I hope you will be able to solve this exercise very easily, and if more questions you get, you can easily solve it without taking much time and without making any mistake. Thank you very much for this class.